Hello, one and all present over here. We Team EXA are presenting a documentary on Dr. Frederick Herzberg.
Frederick Herzberg coined two-factor theory that includes motivation theory and hygiene theory. Before telling you about this theory, let me give a glance of Herzberg's life. Frederick Herzberg attended the City College of New York. Just like all of us, even he had an interesting college life. He left his college in between and joined the army. In army, he was posted as a patrol sergeant. Being in army, he experienced Nazi concentration camp. His experience and talk with the German people in and around areas triggered his interest in motivation. After returning back from the war, he eventually completed his graduation from the same university in 1946. He then moved to the University of Pittsburgh to undertake post-graduation studies in science and public health. He earned his PhD in psychology. He started his research on the workplace while teaching as a psychology professor at Case Western Reserve University. He later moved to the University of Utah, where he held the position of professor of management in the College of Business.
Frederick Herzberg proposed his two-factor theory in 1959. Now let's see, what is this two-factor theory? Herzberg's two-factor theory, also known as Herzberg's motivation and hygiene theory, states that there are certain factors which cause job satisfaction and a different set of factors which cause job dissatisfaction. Not just simply opposing reactions to the same set of factors. This theory on job attitude was born out of Maslow's theory of motivation. Since it was first proposed, it has had a dramatic effect on both theoretical and practical attitudes towards management. Herzberg managed to sum up his theory with the following phrase: "We can expand by stating that the job satisfiers deals with the factors involved in doing the job, whereas the job dissatisfiers deals with the factors which defines the job context." Basically, what Herzberg is saying is that motivator factor affect job satisfaction but have little influence on job dissatisfaction, and hygiene factor affect job dissatisfaction but have little influence on satisfaction.
Now it's time to see what hygiene factors are. Typically, hygiene factor includes good working condition, quality of supervision, good salary, job security, company policies and administration, interpersonal relation within organization. And now it's time to motivate our employees. And how we do it? These are the factors that will serve the purpose. Number one, achievement. Number two, recognition for achievement. Number three, responsibility for task. Number four, interest in the job. Number five, advancement in the higher level job. And number fifth, last but not the least, growth.
Combining the hygiene and motivation factors results in four scenarios. 1. High hygiene plus high motivation. This is the ideal situation where employees are highly motivated and have few complaints. 2. High hygiene plus low motivation. In this situation, employees have few complaints but are not highly motivated. 3. Low hygiene plus high motivation. In this situation, employees are motivated but have lots of complaints. 4. Low hygiene plus low motivation. This is the worst situation. Unmotivated employees with lots and lots of complaints.
Two-factor theory was coined in 1959 and today, my friends, in 2015. Although decades have passed, but these two important factors are still considered to be pillars in a successful management. unlike Maslow, who came up with very little data that could support his ideas, Herzberg and others have presented considerable empirical evidence to confirm motivation hygiene theory. Although their work has been criticized on the methodological ground. So friends, hope we help you to understand Herzberg's two-factor theory in a better way. Thank you for keeping patience. From Team Exa, have a good day.